Hello guys, welcome back to our channel IELTS Winner. Hope you all are doing fine and staying safe. Today I'm going to tell you about the IELTS exam guesswork for 7th August 2021, and this is for academic students alone. For GT, if I have anything, I will be uploading, but till now I haven't received I don't know anyone who is writing that GT on 7th August. So this is for academic students alone. And also, I'll be telling you one of the important news about the speaking slot booking in India. Okay, so let's see what are the kind of questions that may come on 17th August and what are the level of this. Before moving, do not forget to subscribe to our channel's IELTS Winners and also the new channel IELTS Practice World, where we are uploading time-based sample written by me for you to practice in a time limit, so that you know whether you are able to complete your task under the time limits of 30 minutes, 40 minutes or 60 minutes. This will help you to do self-preparation. So if you are working on your own and if you are preparing on your own, this channel will help you to get the best and prepare you in the most effective way. So do subscribe to both and click on that bell icon and share as much as possible to help everyone who is writing IELTS. Let's start. To first start with listening. Listening will be moderate level. Okay, so on the whole, if you see our previous exam dates of August, as I have already said, that 7th August exam and the last 28th August exam, which is both for academic students only, is going to be moderate level. So if you want to see which is easy and which is moderate or difficult, just go to that video and check which one you should book for. So if you have already booked for 7th August, so listening is going to be moderate. Moderate in the sense you need to listen a bit more attentively. You need to have the skill of taking down notes and you have to have fantastic paraphrasing and listening skills for distractors. So if you have these skills, you will find it easy. But if you haven't practiced well, not done the mock test in time limit, and you haven't got the habit of taking down notes, then well, I'm sorry to say, you may face it difficulty. Okay, so even still you have some time left. So every day practice with 1.25 speed. Take down notes, especially in part 3 and part 4, and listen for that distractors very carefully. Okay, so let's see how part 1. So part 1, as usual, is going to be gap fill, that is one word, notes or table completion. That is going to be easy. Part 2 is going to be MCQs and maps. Map can be moderate level, can be tricky. So you need to work hard on your listening skills for maps, that is your directional language. Part 3 is going to be a bit hard because the large MCQs and matching questions will be very tricky, confusing, paraphrased, as well as totally out of the context. You may say that it may be, what to say? They will totally confuse you with distractors as much as possible, because part 3 is going to be within 3-4 people. So it will be confusing who said what. Everyone will be saying the same topic, but what you need to select will be quite difficult. So it is very important that you predict what kind of word you need in that fill-up, in that MCQ. What kind of word, what kind of information are you looking for? And then start listening and taking down notes, so that even if you miss something, you have something to refer to. So that is the best backup plan that you may have. Take down notes. Part 4 is going to be moderate one word completion questions. So lots and lots of distractors will be used. So they will keep changing the answers by using distractors like until, unless, whereas, but, no, but I have changed my mind. Unfortunately, it was not done. So they will say lots of words before coming to final answer. So again, predicting the kind of words, whether I need adjective, whether I need verb, whether I need adverb. If you predict what kind of word you need, then you can write down there. And when you start listening, below that, start writing all the words that you heard related to your predicted words, like verb. So whatever verb you hear, write it down. Whatever adjective, if you need adjective, listen to the adjectives and write it down, so that you have something to refer to. So when you read the answer and when you read the question, you will have something to relate and predict. These are when you miss something. Okay, do not rely completely on always guessing work, but these are when you miss out something. So taking down notes, listening to the distractors and practicing. Now when you are practicing, practice at 1.25 speed without fail, because the listening is going to be quite fast. So overall, it's going to be moderate level. So practice as much as possible. For the academic reading, again, it's going to be moderate level. So I would say do all the question types which you think are going to be very easy for you. So if you feel confident with sentence summary completion, flow charts, or one word table notes completion, go for that. Complete the question types which you find easy to do. Do not go for passage wise solving. You may miss out some of the questions that you feel easy because lack of time. So do all the questions that you know first and then go for the difficult ones, so that you are sure that whatever I have done enough correctly and I get the bands. Okay, so do the easy one first and then read patiently. Do not rush or get tensed. Okay, these expected videos, these guessworks are not to scare you, but to tell you the level so that you prepare yourself accordingly. You set your mind that, okay, I need to focus more on reading. I need to focus a little bit more on paraphrasing, so that you are ready. If you see something which is not of your level, you will be still calm, cool, and you will take up strategies that you had practiced already when such kind of questions may come. So this is to prepare you mentally. Okay, so do the easy one first and read calmly, coolly, and look out for the paraphrased versions. So passage one is going to be multiple choice question, summary completion, and yes no not given. The level will be moderate, so paraphrasing will be too much. Passage 2 will be easy. It will be match heading and short questions, that is answer the following, that will be 2 to 3 words. Okay, so this is not going to be very tricky. Match heading is not very difficult if you know the strategies correct. If you want to know the strategies, just go to the reading playlist and get the best strategies that I follow always to get 9 by 9 IELTS. Okay, then passage 3 is going to be multiple choice question, true false not given, and gap fill up type of question, that is sentence summary or notes completion, that will no be no more than 2 words. Okay, so this is going to be moderate because the fill ups may be quite tricky, and multiple choice question can be either one option or choose 2 to 3 options. So you will be given one question and you need to choose 2 out of 5 or 3 out of 7. So those, everything will look same. You need to be sure what answer I am looking for. So just read patiently the question prompts and then go for answering. Next is for writing. So writing task 1 is going to be line, bar, table, or map. So I have already said that know your percentage language, know the directional language, and use proper structure for writing task 1. Do not go for informal language, go for phrases and formal language. Essay types can be your problem solution, that is one paragraph problem, one paragraph solution, or cause solution, again one paragraph cause, second paragraph solution. Next, discuss with opinion, or advantage outweigh disadvantage. Mostly problem solution and discuss opinion. Okay, focus on these type of questions. The essay topics are listed here, and already we have given the list of all the questions that are on these topics. So just go to the video of writing task 2 for July August and look at the questions with the answers that have been given for all these type of topics. So these are the most common ones that are getting repeated again and again from past 2-3 months. So it will help you to know what kind of questions you can expect. Moving to the speaking cue card. Speaking, I would say focus more on your grammar and your fluency. Do not worry about ideas or vocabularies. They come secondary. Your primary focus should be on your fluency, how naturally you are speaking, how fluently you are speaking, and whether you are speaking grammatically correct or not. If your these two areas are perfect, then you can be 100% sure that your marks are going to be good. If you focus more on the content and your vocabularies, you may miss out on the fluency, and that will affect your band very badly. So focus on your fluency first. These are the kind of cue cards that may get repeated, because these are the ones that are getting repeated again and again. So describe a time you wanted to do something but were not successful. So it can be anything, a time when you wanted to do something but were not successful, a time when you started doing something but you failed, or you know someone who started doing something and failed. So these are the kind of questions that may cover in this cue card. Next, again, describing a place, a building, a person, a book, your favorite thing, your favorite place, or anything related to these topics. Describe a natural talent you want to improve or you want to teach someone. This has come in past 3 months, this has come 5 times, that describe a natural talent you want to improve in yourself. So focus on the cue cards that are being repeated again and again. If you are on our website or Telegram channel, you will get all the list of these cue cards with the answers, and you can practice more carefully. So whatever questions come regularly, I have been uploading them. So you can just go through that and see what are the questions that are getting repeated again and again. With whatever cue card, ultimately what I would say is whatever cue card come, do not worry, just be fluent and use lots of adjectives. Learn adjectives to describe a place, to describe a person, to describe a thing. If you know your adjectives and you are fluently using them, it is more to get 7 and 7 plus. Okay, so focus on adjectives and focus on your fluency, of course with grammar, and you will be good to go for 8777. Now, okay, describe a puzzle, song, movie, you know. Okay. So now for the announcement, that is an important news. The important news is that in India now, IDP is not opening the slots for your speaking booking. Okay, so you are not able to book your slots. I have received 2 or 3 students who are getting panicked by saying that they are not able to book. But it is not your fault. The IDP itself has stopped booking slots due to the increasing cases of corona. So your speaking slots will be automatically selected by IDP itself, and it will be informed to you before your exam, that is 1 week before your exams. They will be intimating you through emails. So do not panic or get tensed or keep on checking and trying to book. Just relax, they will choose and get back to you before a week of your exam. Okay, so you will don't waste your time trying to book and getting confused. Just chill, relax, prepare. When they have selected a slot for you, they'll get back to you. This is not permanent. This is only on temporary basis because of corona pandemic. So don't worry about it. They will solve it as soon as they can. So just relax and prepare well. So just go through, just focus more on these type of questions and prepare your strategies and your ideas so that you are ready to take on any question that comes from this. Do subscribe to both of our channels and prepare well. Bye-bye.